Good morning, guys. Got a beetle to look at. We're looking at it with my Canon PowerShot SX60HS at the moment. Not sure if we're in focus. I think we are. I'll put the microscope on it in a minute, but I just thought we'd have a look with the ordinary camera first. I've got a light on it at the moment, which is probably changing the colour a little bit. It is green, or iridescent green. I think it might be a rose chafer, I think they're called. It's a reasonable size. If I put my finger next to it, yeah, it's about the width of my finger. This one unfortunately died. It was under a piece of wood that I moved, and I heard a sort of crunching noise as I moved the piece of wood, and when I lifted it up, this chap was underneath it. So I'm sorry, but I crushed him. So he's got a few sort of loose edges where he's met an untimely death. Anyway, I'll set up the microscope, the Wi-Fi microscope, and see if we can get a closer look at him, her, it. I'll put this camera back on again for the audio. All set up, so my Wi-Fi microscope on its new bracket on the cheap tripod, connected to my phone via Wi-Fi. So if I can press the right button, right, we should now be recording. Always fascinates me that they're covered in hair. Get the focus right. And get it on edge. Right, let's have a look there. Some of my YouTube friends have got hold of these microscopes and are beginning to find some of the issues with them, like the focus wheel on the top here is a bit stiff, to be honest. And when you move it, you're actually moving the whole microscope. So it's often easier to get the focus and then actually push the microscope a bit to alter the focus. Just by putting some weight on it. You're changing the actual focal point. Oh, but not that much. You know, just by putting some weight around it, like I'm pushing down on the legs a bit, we're changing exactly where the microscope is focusing on the beetle. Like I say, it's the fact they're covered in hair that fascinates me. You think they got a shiny back, but when you look close up, it's covered in hair. Now, the other thing I do is remember to stop the video. And restart it just in case it runs out of memory so I don't lose everything. Right, we'll flick it over on its back. One thing I don't use is this extra zoom bit. Give it a little try. Oh, knocked it. At that level, adjusting the focus is very fussy. And I've completely lost the focus now. No, let's take that back out again. And you have to remember we're using a pretty cheap microscope here. So we can't expect the best. But it would have been nice to have had a electronic zoom or focus. Just gonna press that rotate button. Oh, I see that rotates it all the way around. Oh, somebody wanted a close-up of how the legs join the body. And I can't quite imagine what you mean there. And it's not like they got hinges and screws. I really can't see whether the focus is that good or not. I think I've just messed up the focus completely now. Yeah. Okay, I'll just save that bit. I'll just try and maneuver it so we can look straight at its head. Right, this is going to go horribly wrong because I'm trying to adjust the focus. As soon as I touch that, I lose it completely. Trying to look at its eye. As soon as I touch the focus, stop again for a minute. That'll do. Right, we'll go and see what we've got.
Thanks for watching. You'll find more information down in the video description. You might like to watch that video up there. And you might like to subscribe over there.